Hey there, and welcome to today's ORTHOS Liquid Systems video chat. I'm Stuart Humphreys, Director of Filtration Technologies for ORTHOS.
As the leader in nozzle-based filter systems and products, how does ORTHOS know how to select the correct nozzle product for your application? This video is part 4 of a 4-part series regarding filter nozzle or strainer construction. Here I will discuss tailpipe construction for air scour applications for monolithic or steel plate underdrains. As scour air is introduced into the plenum of false floor underdrain systems, it collects and builds an air blanket evenly across the filter footprint and downward from the top of the plenum, displacing the water. One may see an air blanket in a test column in our ORTHOS Research Center. Scour air enters the nozzle through metering holes or slots manufactured in the nozzle tailpipe. The size and location of these holes determine the depth of the air blanket at a specific airflow rate per nozzle. Once air scour is terminated, the residual blanket above the top metering hole is evacuated through an air bleed hole located at the top of the nozzle tailpipe. ORTHOS has developed a proprietary calibrated software model that calculates blanket depths at varying airflow rates for a specific nozzle tailpipe construction. Recently, ORTHOS was contracted to supply replacements of all nozzles at a competitor's problematic installation. We input the nozzle tailpipe dimensions into our model, which immediately raised a concern about the location of the air-water divide line relative to the existing nozzle's air metering holes. At the 2 scour air flow rates desired by the utility, the predicted blanket depths were very near the large metering hole at the bottom of the tailpipe. Engineering personnel performed a test in our ORTHOS Research Center and confirmed the model output. When the air-water divide line is near or within a metering hole or slot, maldistribution of scour air may occur across the footprint of a filter. This is not proper design. Though contractors try their best to have a false floor to be completely level, in reality it's not. Most industry specifications allow plus or minus 2 millimeters. This graphic shows that a floor elevation variance can undesirably create significantly different airflow rates from nozzle to nozzle. Nozzles without air metering holes and instead constructed with air metering slots only at the tailpipe bottom will also likely create maldistribution. Effective design locates the air-water divide line between air metering holes or an air metering hole in the nozzle tailpipe bottom. Slots are not typically used. For this example project, ORTHOS delivered nozzles with a dual air metering hole tailpipe that provides buffers for variance of delivered airflow rate. For concurrent air-water backwash applications, the air blanket is compressed within the plenum when backwash pumps are turned on, which adds some design complexity. ORTHOS engineering staff will select the proper combination of air metering hole quantity, location, and size to ensure excellent distribution during concurrent backwash as well as the air-only initial phase. Designs may be easily confirmed in our ORTHOS Research Center.
Please contact me or your local ORTHOS representative for any of your filtration, contactor, or ion exchange needs. And subscribe to the ORTHOS YouTube channel. Follow us on Twitter or LinkedIn me. I'm Stuart Humphreys. Talk with you again soon.